we have to focus on the slide structure. The slide structure basically contains some sort of theme or design which is provided by the PowerPoint. So what we can do, either we have to select the standard theme or create our own theme. As stated earlier, several standard templates and themes are available. We have to choose the most relevant to your topic or create a new one. What is essential is that it should be in tune with the concept being presented. Stick up to the color scheme of the theme. Usually, the default schemes are graceful. Changing them frequently may give an annoying look to your slides. Choose the appropriate size for the slides based on the contents to be presented. There are two sizes of the slide which are provided by the PowerPoint. We may choose between the standard 4:3 or widescreen 16:9 slide size. Now, on a slide, we should write the points and not the complete sentence. They are supposed to be spoken by the speaker. Otherwise, if you are writing everything you are going to speak, then your presence becomes obsolete. A slide should include minimal points, ideally 4 to 6 points per slide. This may change based on the need of the topic. Like if I am presenting a procedure that consists of 7 or 8 steps, I may prefer to keep it on a one slide only. Next, avoid cluttering. Use the keywords and phrases only. No paragraphs, please, strictly. Again, there are exceptions. Like if I have to present a definition of certain topic or I have to present a quotation, then in that case, I may go for the paragraphs. But then here also, the presenter should not keep on reading the entire text. Also, we must check the other formatting options like the line spacing, the indents and the alignments of various objects on the slide. Now, we'll look towards some bad example of a slide structure where we have presented one paragraph as a whole. I will just read it down. If the contents are presented as paragraph, it becomes difficult to read. They are written in sentence format, which are difficult to read for the presenter as well as the audience. The presenter may lose the eye contact with the audience, who are also busy reading the text. Ultimately, they will lose connectivity with the speaker and mainly the interest in your presentation. So, believe me, this is the moment where you have lost your audience. Now, we'll see what exactly can be done with the same slide. So, what I have done, I have modified the same slide with a good example how it can be presented. The contents of the earlier slide are now presented in the form of points, making neatly organized. The presenter has to simply read a single point for his reference and elaborate on that particular point. Now, as we have mentioned that the slide should not say anything and everything should be presented in the form of points, we'll see how the points has to be displayed. Let a single point appear at a time. What is the advantage of this? It prevents the audience from reading ahead. Otherwise, when I am explaining the first point, probably the audience may be busy reading the fourth point. It also helps the audience to concentrate on you, since only the current point which I am going to explain is displayed on the screen. So naturally, they will be listening to you now. Again, the same thing will help you to keep your presentation focused. The next thing that we must remember with the slide structure is numbering the slide. It is a good practice to number your slide, although it is not essential. If you have chosen to use the slide numbers, then place the numbers of the current slide, preferably in the footer. Put total number of slides along with the current slide number. This is especially useful when your presentation is being evaluated. So it helps the audience or evaluator and even yourself to keep track of your presenter. The evaluator may get an idea of how much of your presentation is remaining. Now we'll see some bad examples of slide structure. I have created one slide that explains the tricks for designing a good password. Okay, now I'm going to present some tips that helps you to create a good password. So I will be going through this slide. Password should be difficult to guess for others. Choose the password that you can relate with something you always remember. Now this will help you to recall it faster, but then it will be difficult for the others to guess. For example, WYSIWYG, and the related phrase to this word is what you see is what you get. Now see, I have tried to present this concept in a very interactive and very interesting manner, but since I have displayed all the points at a time on the screen, when probably I am explaining the first point, that is password should be difficult to guess, okay, by that time the audience may be very much focused on that WYSIWYG, that is YCWYG. What is that? Okay, what is the related phrase and something like that. So my primary aim has been spoiled here. Whatever I am going to explain is not really worth achieved. So what we can do is we'll see the next example of a same slide. So what I have done here is that I have displayed the same contents. Only thing is that the points are displayed one at a time. So now when I am explaining this for the first time, only the first point will appear and I will be talking on this point. Then after elaborating on this point, the second point will appear, and then the third example, which is that WWEWANADTD. Okay, now what I am going to do here is that I have just displayed this and I will ask the audience to go back. Okay, I will just go back and ask them to recall what was the password. Naturally the password will not be recalled because it was very much difficult. Okay, but then since I have related a particular phrase, this phrase, okay, now I will show this phrase: water, water everywhere and not a drop to drink. Okay, now I have chosen the first character for a password. Here the audience will get a message about how to create the powerful passwords. Next thing to remember is avoid crowding on the slide. Lots of images and text on a single slide creates a cluttered look. So use the space effectively. Be generous to leave the enough space to be free on the slide. Map the text according to the slide background. So wherever there are some graphics or some dark points on the slide, either these points should be left alone or appropriate color of the font should be chosen. It is observed that sometimes the projection of the projector and the screen is not aligned properly. So some portion of your slide is displayed outside of the screen, or rather it is not displayed properly. So we keep giving excuses that if it was properly aligned, you would have been able to view it nicely. Also, if the slide contains text at the bottom like this, then some viewers, especially those who are sitting at the back side, won't be able to see it. So what they have to do is they have to either raise their head each time or simply they ignore the contents, which you certainly would not like to happen. So what we can do, we should keep all the text and objects within a reasonable distance from the edges of the slide, that is maintaining margins from all sides of the slide. we may say that this is the safe zone for this particular slide.